Good morning to all. Welcome to the video session. I am Mrs. R. Bhuvana Indumadi, belonging to the Department of Home Science. Today, we are going to see about an overview of diabetes mellitus. So, diabetes mellitus is characterized by, ma'am, slide in. Diabetes mellitus is a chronic metabolic disorder that prevents the body to utilize the glucose completely or partially. It is characterized by rise to glucose concentration in the blood and alteration of carbohydrate, protein and fat metabolism in the body. This can be due to the failure of insulin in the formation. This is simply to understand, we eat many number of foods that provide energy. The main source of energy contributed by carbohydrate, so that what happens, the carbohydrate food which after intake it converted into sugar, that is glucose, which is after digestion. So that glucose which enter into the blood and go to all parts of the body to give energy in the presence of insulin. Whereas your pancreas has to secrete insulin, which is the key molecule which has to take up the glucose molecule to the cell where it has to produce energy. So next, this is the slide which shows about the healthy pancreas and the diabetic pancreas. If it's healthy, you can see the insulin which is secreted normally, which means the glucose which we meet with the key molecule which is attached to the insulin receptor cell, which is gives energy. So this is the type 1. In type 1, the pancreas is unable and failure of production of insulin, which does not have any insulin key molecule. Only the glucose molecule will enter into the cell, but is not in the cell, in the bloodstream. So what happens, the blood circulation will have high rise blood glucose level. In type 2, the insulin may be secreted in a partially, maybe impaired sometimes. So what happened? The half of the insulin will be secreted. So what happened? The key molecule insulin will uptake the glucose. Only the half of the insulin receptor will receive the insulin. So that the cell failed to respond to insulin properly. So coming to the prevalence, diabetes is increasingly seen in India. The multicentric ICMR study shown that the prevalence of diabetes is 2.5% in urban and 1.8% in rural population. So one in every 8 individuals in India is diabetic. The average age of onset is around 40 years in India, wherever in by other countries it is 50. Next, this is the type of diabetes mellitus. There are different types of diabetes mellitus, type 1, type 2 and gestational diabetes. So what is type 1 diabetes mellitus? It is an insulin dependent autoimmune disease. Type 2, insulin resistant lifestyle disease. Type 3, gestational diabetes, which is the elevated blood sugar will be seen during pregnancy. So here is the difference between type 1 and type 2. Type 1 occur at the younger age, which is otherwise called as IDDM, that is insulin dependent diabetes mellitus, also called as juvenile diabetes mellitus. This is type 2, which occur in the middle age or in elderly stage. Here, the young children will be underweight, usually underweight, with a normal BMI, not obese. Here, the adult person or elderly person will be usually overweight and obese. This type 1 will not have any family history. This have the family history usually. The symptoms of will be the short duration in type 1 diabetes. In type 2, the symptoms will be present in 1 or year. Diabetic coma will be present in the disease of type 1 diabetes, that is diabetic acidosis or ketoacidosis. Whereas in diabetic coma will not be present in type 2. Insulin is moreover required for type 1 diabetes. Insulin is not necessarily required for type 2 diabetes. The previous pregnancy, previous diabetes will be seen in the pregnancies. So these are the differences we will see. Next, these are the causes of diabetes. So causes of type 1 diabetes. In major, there are two factors which contribute to this causes. First one is genetic and second is environmental factor. The genetic is the HLA class 2 gene which is responsible for the type 1 diabetes. You can see in this picture, the pancreas is unable to produce insulin. There is decreased insulin production, which reaches the blood vessel, increased glucose level due to low insulin. The muscle is unable to use the glucose due to low insulin. This is type 1. So what happens, moreover, ketoacidosis takes place. So glucose, glycogen and protein breakdown causes ketoacidosis. So coming to the environmental factors, infection of, because of the virus caused by Coxsackie virus. And next thing is acute stress. Acute stress is nothing but any physical injury and stress upon the patients. So diet, coming to the diet, introducing of cow's milk before 2 months. It has the antibody of bovine serum albumin, which is the factor to cause diabetes 1. Fourth one is immunological factor. It is an autoimmune disease. Next, coming to the cause of type 2 diabetes, it is genetically same factors, it is genetic and environmental factors, the main factor. Genetic is due to X syndrome, that is a metabolic syndrome. Environmental factor, you can see this picture, maybe the family history, lack of exercise, unhealthy eating and overeating. So lifestyle, lifestyle is who's underactive and obese, age. It can be caused at the age of maybe adult or elderly. Abdominal fat, which plays an important role, whereas the BHR is nothing but waist-width ratio. That is, increased waist-width ratio can lead to type 2 diabetes. Pregnancy, whereas the placental hormone placing the burden on insulin secretion. Next, insulin resistance due to abnormal insulin molecule. So these are the some symptoms of diabetes mellitus. This is the initial observation, which includes that is polydipsia, polyphagia, polyuria, weight loss in type 1 and obesity in type 2. So what is polydipsia? Increased thirst. What is polyuria? Increased hunger. What is polyuria? Frequent urination. Next is the classical clinical symptoms. Clinical laboratory test. This laboratory test will show which are the patients with diabetes. Maybe the first test is glycosuria, hyperglycemia, abnormal glucose, tolerance test. So what is glycosuria? Glucose will be present abnormally in the urine. Hyperglycemia. Without insulin, the elevated blood sugar will be seen. Abnormal glucose tolerance test will be seen later. Next test, possible other symptoms are blurred vision, skin irritation, infection, weakness, that is loss of strength and decreased healing capacity. Continued symptom, what will be the symptom will be continually seen are fluid and electrolytic imbalance, acidosis, that is ketosis and ketonuria, coma. So next coming to the diagnosis, how we can diagnose one to have diabetes. So these are the four preliminary and confirmatory tests. The first test is glycosuria, presence of abnormal glucose, which is in the urine, ketonuria, presence of ketone bodies in the urine. Next is random blood sugar. While we're taking the random blood sugar, it will be increase of 200 mg, which indicates diabetes mellitus. Glucose tolerance test is the confirmatory test of diabetes. So what happens? But in the confirmatory, the fasting level will be at 80 to 120 and the postprandial level will be 120 to 180 mg. So coming to the complications of diabetes mellitus, they are different, acute and chronic. What will be in the acute stages? We have already seen diabetic ketoacidosis, hyperglycemia, elevated blood sugar level, hyperosmolar state, that is imbalance of electrolytic balance, and hypoglycemia, low level of sugar level. Diabetic foot ulcer, infection. The chronic, coming to the chronic, microvascular and macrovascular. What is microvascular? Whereas the blood vessels reach the micro, that is retinopathy, eye damage, which creates eye damage, and retinopathy, nephropathy is nothing but the kidney will get damaged, neuropathy, the neurons will be getting activated. So what is the macrovascular, which is associated with the heart disease, that is accelerated atherosclerosis, myocardial infarctions, stroke, and lower extremity gangrenes. Next, coming to the important aspect, that is dietary management and guidelines. Principles of the diet. What should be the principle? The moderate carbohydrate, high protein, and low fat, high vitamins and minerals, and high fiber should be included. Daily energy intake must be estimated by considering the following facts like age, sex, weight, and activity. So what happens? How much energy we need? So this is the outline. First, we should need the treatment of component of diabetic diet, nutrition intervention for type 1 and type 2. So there is a difference between type 1 and type 2. For each case, we have to concentrate which is the type. So next is body weight management. If in the case the type 2 diabetes is obese, we have to concentrate in body weight management. Coming to the major component, that is which is the energy giving product, that is carbohydrate, protein and fat. So carbohydrate, we have to choose what type of carbohydrate to be intake. It should be a complex carbohydrate, not a simple carbohydrate. Coming to the glycemic index, what is glycemic index? It is the glycemic load which has to recognize the type 2 diabetic patient. So what happens? The glycemic index is nothing but, for example, we have to, the patient has to take chapati, wheat chapati, rather than wheat kanji, because it has high glycemic index. Which one? Wheat chapati has high glycemic index rather wheat kanji. So what happens, the glycemic load and glycemic index is more important in the case of diabetic patient. For example, carrot, which has a high glycemic index, which has a low concentration in the carbohydrate. So what happens, some foods has high glycemic index, I mean low glycemic index, like ice cream, fried foods and pongal, which have a high glycemic load. So what is therefore to be understood is, the patient should take only the soluble dietary fiber which has low glycemic index and low glycemic load foods. So some of the energy exchange system to be followed, and high fiber food has to be followed. Coming to the protein, high quality of protein which is essential to the body, that is, the patient has to take a good protein, good number of protein, that is, which has essential amino acids, that's to maybe in the rich in, I mean, meat, chicken, etc. Coming to the dietary fat and cholesterol, the patient has to put in such unsaturated fats, not in saturated fats. Salt and high sodium, maybe when the patient is hypertensive, we have to be restricted to the salt and sodium diet, alcohol and additive sweeteners and diabetic foods. Treatment of cold. What is the treatment? What cold should be followed? Optimize the blood glucose control to achieve and maintain the reasonable body weight. Optimize the lipid and lipoprotein profile. Reduce the blood pressure to prevent or delay the progression of chronic complication. Promote overall health through the optimal nutrition. So this is the nutrition recommendation for a diabetic management. So there is no one diabetes diet that suits all. Modification of normal, well-balanced, based on the nutritional need of an individual, which may be expressed in terms of calorie, fat and protein. So each person with diabetes is different. So setting up the diabetic diet by calculating, the first thing we have to calculate the calorie need of an individual, determine the dietary distribution of protein, carbohydrate and fat, dividing the daily prescription into practical and healthy meal. So this is a table which describes the energy requirement for an individual according to his body weight, according maybe per day. So there is a weight status which is obese, overweight, normal and underweight. This is an activity level. This is an energy requirement for the particular person. Maybe he is obese, doing a light activity, he required 20 kilocalories per kg per body weight. When he is doing a moderate activity, he needs 25 kilocalories per kg per body weight. Is accordingly given according to the weight status. Maybe in underweight, the heavy activity is a person who needs 45 to 50 kilocalories per day per kg of the body weight. This is the calorie allowances may be decreasing with the age. According to, adult may be weighing at 18 to 20, 39 years, the above which is prescribed. Maybe the age is 40 to 59, maybe it should be less than this for 5%. Maybe above 60 years old, it should be about 10% less. The basic nutritional strategy, we have to follow, first we have to distribute the food throughout the day. It should be small, frequent meal, appropriate time spacing should be there. So 4 hours interval should be there, and then choose healthy carbohydrate, protein and fat. For in case of type 1 diabetes, the food should be synchronized with the insulin therapy. The most of the people will need 3 meals plus 3 snacks to avoid hyperglycemia. The condition is overweight. When the condition is overweight with type 2 diabetes, calorie is restricted to 1200 to 1500 kilocalories. 3 main meals should be followed, the snacks which is not usually required. When the patient is underweight, an ideal weight or underweight of type 2 diabetes, 3 main meals, the small mid-meal, that is mid-evening or mid-morning snack meal is provided. So coming to the consistency and variety, the consistent eating habit should be followed. Try to eat same amount of food at the same time, include a variety of food. So this is a periodic plate. The half of the plate should be contain vegetable, at least 2 vegetables a day. So whole grains should be taken, and meat will be alternative of fish and lean meat, chicken, lentils can be taken. So this is the dietary management of diabetes mellitus. The dietary calorie should be 60 to 70% from carbohydrate, 15 to 20% from fat, and 15 to 25% from fat. If no insulin is given, the calorie can be distributed as such. That is 33% in all lactams, that is breakfast and mid morning should be 33%, lunch and tea should be 33%, and dinner and bedtime should be 33%. Simple sugar should be avoided. Calorie should be adjusted for the insulin patient. A mixture of oil is preferred than the single oil, that is unsaturated fats like polyunsaturated fatty acids and monounsaturated fatty acids. High protein diet is essential to increase in insulin secretion. Complex carbohydrate fiber, it can be included in the diet. That is 20 to 25%, 20 to 40 gram per 1000 kilocalorie. Water soluble fiber has the greatest hypoglycemic and cholesterolemic effect, so that which includes whole grains, fenugreek and legumes, etc. Timely intake of food, which is necessary between snack meal to prevent hypoglycemia. Patients should avoid fasting and feasting. Sodium restricted hypertensive diabetic diet. So these are the foods to be included. Some of the foods to be included: simple sugar, sweet, dried fruits, cake, candy, fried fruits, alcohol, nuts and jaggery. These are the foods which is eaten in moderate, fat, cereals and pulses. That too, it should be from red meat. Foods are permitted are, these are the sum of the list: green veg, vegetables, onion, mince, salad, skim milk and buttermilk can be preferred. Let us review. What is diabetes? The body does not produce enough insulin. Body cells are not receptive to the insulin being produced. What is the complication? Fatigue, dehydration, and damage to the vital organ. Some of the ways to manage through diet and exercise. So, hence to conclude, with a proper diet, exercise, drug, and medication and education, diabetes mellitus can be controlled and managed without any macrovascular complications. Thank you.